Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode in this Let's Play series with me, Kaizen. Now today is going to be somewhat of a subscriber special. We talked about subscribers a little bit last time and I have to say a massive thank you because the response, guys, has been fantastic. So we're going to jump right into this one and I did say to anyone that subscribed you would get your names on the town buildings. Now we ended up getting a lot more subscribers than I anticipated, so I've had to go not just into the town but over to the village, which we'll see in a minute, and even out to this little guy here. So the first one here, this is Keechy Games YouTube. Thank you very much, Keechy, for your subscription. We're going to go now and have a look at all the other signs, because I didn't want to just do them. I obviously wanted to show you guys that I had done them so that you know where your buildings are, and hopefully you guys like what I've done there. Now, so here's the these are just the general town buildings, and I'm hoping to find a use for all of them, but at the moment a lot of them are empty. So we've got the Angel Urena 589, we have Alex Heim, we've got Tyler Good, and this one is a long name. We've got Karen Albert Angel or Angel Valero. Sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong, but thank you for your subscription to all of you. Going over to the restaurant now, Starchy Bread. I mean, I thought that was a good name for the food hall. We've got the bread right there, so thank you, Starchy. That's where you're going to go. And coming over to these now, we have a house here, and this is Dusty Lamps. Now, I've mentioned Dusty before. He plays on this, it's a single player, but it is a server, and he does come on from time to time. So when he comes to my village, he's now got a house, which he might decorate at some point. We'll see about that. And at these two houses here, we've got their Zuba Fizz Gaming, and we have Goliathon's Universe. So thanks to all of you. Now, I'm still got to show you some more, but just while I'm going there, I thought I'd explain it a bit. So I've had some people message me on Instagram, and some people just subscribe and haven't messaged me. So basically the way this is going is, if you haven't otherwise specified, then it's just your YouTube name that goes onto the door. And for those of you who messaged me on Instagram, thanks very much. Instagram's been going great. And I know that a lot of people are enjoying the posts and things I'm doing on there. If you do want to connect to my Instagram, it's just Kaizen_MC, and there's a link to it in my channel art picture. And so now we're moving on with this. We have AJ's. This is AJ Plays Games. You've got this little house here, which was the farmhouse. And then we've got these trading units, which eventually I do want to put some villages into. So we've got their fiber optics on that one. Oops, ran into a log. Adam Plays 29, and it's Fluffy. So that's the three that we have in this area. So, as I said, I have been connecting with people on Instagram. People have been messaging me saying, oh, they want a different name to their YouTube name for their building, their sign placement. And that's been fine so far because it's been manageable with the numbers that I've been getting. However, guys, I'm not going to be able to do that from now on, unfortunately, because just the sheer number of subscribers that I'm getting, it just doesn't make sense. So, if you do subscribe from now on, you will still get your name, and I'm going to go and show you guys what I'm going to do about that in a second. But essentially, what I will do is only those guys that show publicly their YouTube subscriptions will be listed, because that means I will receive an email, and I can just go through my email inbox, look at everyone that's subscribed, and get on with doing this. Because obviously it does take a little bit of time for me to do all this as well, and I know that you guys want me to crack on with the content and not just be doing this all the time. So a little building here, and we've got It's Sam for the Win. Round this way, now this is the building I built, of course. We have Starling Fire Gaming on that one. So some of these are channels, some of them are individuals. It's a whole mixed bunch we've got here. Flutter Lily is that one. Another one over here, we have Danielle. That's someone who messaged me and she said that she wanted just her first name up there, so that's fine. Now in here we have Lucas Kelp, and this one is Iron Aura. If the villager gets out of my way, we can see that one. And I think there's a couple more still to go around here. Yes, so we got My Private Life, and I thought it's kind of a funny one to put here because it's sort of a little private house. Sort of under the path a little bit, and just a little house kind of fits. I don't know, hope you like that one. And this one up here, we have the Wolf DK. This is this building here. So I tried to do it fairly, guys, and give everyone the same kind of building rather than giving someone a really good building or something that was really might be considered a lot better than the rest. So hopefully you guys think that's all done fairly. And oops, I might need to put my elytra wings on, mightn't I? Hard to fly without them, guys. So I'm going to show you guys now what I'll be doing for the future, just so everybody's aware. And I might have to end the episode, obviously not now, I mean later on, might have to end the episode by adding a few names to the new subscriber area, essentially, that I'm about to show you. And because we are getting them quite quickly, and I don't know if there will be more by the time I finish recording all of this. So essentially what I thought I'd do is add your names to the mining area and give each subscriber a mineshaft. Now, I know this is not a new idea, I have seen other people do this, but in fairness, it's kind of hard to think of good ideas because the buildings, I mean, I like that idea, but it's just very difficult to have enough buildings and to keep up with the demand. Whereas the mineshafts, I have a lot of these, I will have a lot more of these, and I thought it would be a good way of doing it. So essentially, you'll get a sign up there, and that will be your name and your mineshaft. So I hope you like that idea, guys. And as I say, I might have to end the episode with a few of those subscribers that will go onto there. So anyway, that's about it for the intro. That was just me thanking those subscribers there and showing you that I had done the signs as I promised. So now we're going to go and crack on with today's main idea. Hi guys, as you can see, we are back at the village. Just very quickly, one thing I meant to do last time was add doors to the buildings that didn't have them. So there's that one there, the Fluffaluff tribe building. And if I go up here, there's one more house that also did not have a door. So I just want everyone to feel like they've had the same experience here as much as possible. And so that was Danielle, the other one there. So now every building should have a door. Okay guys, so that is the subscriber part of this episode done for now. To any subscribers who have not been mentioned yet, you will be mentioned at the end. But it's probably just that I didn't get your subscription come through until I've done this recording. So now on to today's project. But just quickly, before we get onto what we're doing today, I wanted to mention this place. This is, of course, the villager breeding area. Now, this was on the last couple of episodes, guys, that we were working on this. And I just wanted to explain that I'm not going to keep doing this every episode until it's done, because it would probably be quite a lot of episodes and would be very boring for you guys. There wouldn't be a whole heap of differentiation between episodes, wouldn't be much variety. So essentially, I felt like let's get this project as an ongoing one and we'll get on with a few other things. Which brings us to what we're going to do today. Now, for a long time, I've been wanting to find one of those ice biomes where I can get loads of packed ice. So I have explored a lot of this world and I haven't yet found one. And I have no idea how long it's going to take me to find one, but from what I've done already, I get the feeling I'm going to have to go pretty far to get to one of these places. However, I do think it'll be worth it because having the packed ice is really useful for water elevators and for transportation roads so you can go very quickly on and that kind of thing. So, the plan now is for me to, pretty much mostly off camera, unless I find something of interest, explore the world and find a packed ice biome, essentially. Now, I've been off this way a lot. The mesa's roughly off in this direction. Off that way, just past the mob farm and that there is not a lot going on. It's things like there's, you know, forests and swamps and that sort of thing. But it seems to be the hotter biomes that go that way. And this way, just past the tree farm and all that there is an ocean, and then there's desert, and eventually it becomes like a mushroom area, and there's a water temple nearby. But I've travelled on past there, and again, had no joy. But the one direction I haven't yet been in loads is sort of off this way, sort of past the stronghold. And the reason for that is because Dusty, who I've mentioned before, who plays on this server sometimes, although it is a single player, it is essentially a server that we play on. He lives up that way, so I was sort of letting him get on with his stuff up there. But I think I'm going to have to go like thousands of blocks and it won't interrupt him too much if I go on past him. Plus, I'm pretty sure we can share an ice biome if we do both happen to find the same one. Not really too much of an issue, is it? They're quite big. So, the plan is not just to go there and get a load of resources, which is exactly what I do want to do. So I'm going to take a load of shulker boxes with me and fill them up. Take a lot of pickaxes with me as well to make sure I can cope with all that demand, even though this one should last quite a while yet. But not just to do all the collecting of resources, but also, I would quite like to build some sort of ice base so I can return there in the future. Depending on how far away it is, this may not be a regular thing, but we'll see how we go on that one. But yeah, essentially return there in the future and have a little base set up so I'm good to go for next time. Also, I thought it'd be a pretty cool build and hopefully you guys will like that once it's done. So what I do need to do is make sure I take everything with me, because obviously if I go thousands and thousands of blocks off, I am not going to want to come back and redo things. So that's why I've got the end chest on me. Obviously this thing is an absolute lifesaver with all the things you can put in there, especially now with the shulker boxes. and I'm going to have a little think about what I might want to design this ice base out of, get a whole heap of resources in my inventory, take them with me, and the next update will probably be either when we found something cool or when we're in the wonderful ice biome. So I will see you guys then. Well, we are about now ready to go off and find this ice biome. Just going to quickly stack up on food before I do that. So go to the restaurant here, get some of this stuff going. And I have spare food in my end chest. I'm taking an end chest with me, so that'll be fine. And I know technically it's an ender chest, but for some reason I always say end chest. Don't know why that is. Anyway, so I've got enough stuff now for my travels, I think. I'll just show you guys what I'm taking to give you an idea of what resources I'm taking, but I don't like the look of this creeper over here. He's just stood there trying to look unsuspicious. I think he's going to blow up any minute. Kill all my horses over there. Anyway, so as you can see here, I've got brown hardened clay, nether brick, the obsidian and the flint and steel. That's so I can make a nether portal whilst I'm there. And just thinking about it, actually, I'm going to whack some nether rack in here as well. And then I can use that to make some fires, because I think fire will probably look very good in the ice biome, because you sort of, you know, you have to keep warm and such, don't you? So I'll put some of that in there in a second. And in here we've got all the wood and stuff, so I've gone for the dark wood, and obviously just some basics there for a base. Now, as you can see from that those two shulker boxes, I am going mainly for darker colours, because the ice biome is obviously very light coloured, a lot of white, a lot of light blues and that sort of thing. So I think that the dark colours will contrast quite nicely and will look pretty good against that. Now, I won't know till I get there, and I very much hope I'm right, because obviously, as we said, this will probably be some distance, but I think it should work. And I'm just thinking, actually, you know what? If I'm going to take these with me, let's see in decorations, do we have iron bars? No. Maybe we have them over in the iron chest. But I find quite often the fire looks pretty good with the iron bars around it. There we go. There's a good few there, and I do have some iron in my end chest if I need more. But I think that will probably be a good thing to take, because I can probably create some good effects with that. So what I'm going to do, I'm putting this into shulker boxes. One, because it saves on storage, and two, because I can put them in my end chest, and then if I die, at least I don't lose everything. So I'll keep all this armor on me, because it's very good armor, but it's very easily replaceable as well. Whereas the materials, like, I don't want to lose all my dark oak, for example, and have to go and cut down a dark oak forest again for like an hour or something to replenish it all, because that can get very annoying and a bit boring. So we'll just put all this in here, and then we're about ready to head off on our exploration. Keep all these rockets on me, and we are good to go. So now I will head off on my way, and hopefully it doesn't take too long to find one of these, but we'll just have to see how we go on that one. So now, just thinking, Elytra. I have two ways of saying that. I say Elytra, I say Elytra. I've heard it pronounced differently. I'm not sure which one's sort of correct. I think it probably depends on where you live. Okay, just wanted to check I had the spare Elytra, let's go with that, in my end chest there, because depending on how far I go, the durability might go down, and although it has menu on it, it might be a bit of a pain having to sort that out. Alright, so here we go, let's take off, said heading off in this way, and yeah, I'm pretty much just going to fly in a straight line. Now, I'm going to get up pretty high here, just turn that sound down a little bit, because I've been this way before, I've flown to Dusty's base before. Let me get my cords up just so I know how high I am. And I've been past the stronghold before, and we're not at that point yet. And I know there's no ice biomes in there, so I'm just going to get up very high and then just let myself coast downwards for a couple of thousand blocks. And that'll be the point where we start looking. So guys, hopefully we will find this one soon, and then I'll give you guys another update. Guys, I don't know what to tell you. We've been searching for so long, or more to the point, I've been searching here for so long, I mean hours and hours, and you know, I just couldn't find the ice biome, so I'm really sorry. I guess we're just going to have to head home. So I'll put my view back into looking forwards. Ah! You didn't believe me, did you guys? You didn't think I was going to give up that easily? Come on. We're taking this seriously. We're going to find this thing. We found this thing. Look at this. Have to say, took me literally hours. Just to give you an idea, here's my cords. So we're about negative 10,000 and 2,000. So, yeah, pretty much like 11,000 blocks-ish from my base. Pretty long way, guys. I mean, bearing in mind that you don't just fly straight there. Obviously, I will now because I know where it is. But when you don't know where it is, you have to look around a bit Yeah, this has been a bit of a long day, but it's very worth it. I mean, we've got this ice biome now, and we can get ice, and look how quickly you get the ice as well. That wonderful packed ice. Just put my helmet back on, getting a little bit cold here. And yeah, I mean, that's awesome. This is exactly what we wanted. Got this really cool lake here that we can sprint across pretty quickly. And let's get those cords away because I'm hiding this beautiful scenery. And it is beautiful, isn't it? I mean, this biome is a wonderful looking biome, isn't it? Very unique and real amazing addition to the Minecraft game. So we found it, and now we want to set up our base, of course. So I'm just trying to think, trying to find the best place to do that. So essentially, what we want is somewhere where we can go and get lots and lots of packed ice. But I'm thinking maybe let's have a base that looks nice, and we keep some of these natural structures around it, and then go and have a little mining area somewhere nearby where there's loads of this stuff. I think pretty much though, the best bet is just to find somewhere that's got loads of these structures close together, and then just pretty much go crazy on them. Now I'm gonna look to make essentially a bit of a packed ice farm, and I've got a few ideas on how I'm going to do that. So I'm gonna look for the right area. I'm going to set a few things up, and then I'll come back and we'll go through how we're going to do that farm together. Okay, guys, so as you can see, I've started putting together a bit of a base. Bad news is, I am out of dark oak planks. Sorry, not planks, the logs, this stuff right here. So I'm going to need more materials in order to complete this build. Now, I'm pretty certain that I flew past the dark oak biome on my way here that isn't too far away. So I might see a dark oak biome on my way back, be able to get a load of that stuff, and then come back here. But in case that doesn't happen, I'll just have to come back and complete it another time. I just thought I'd show you guys this for now as to how we'd started here. And essentially, there's like a raised area. Generally, when you see these sort of snow log cabin type of things, they are raised up off the ground. And I think there's a reason for all that. It's to do with the snow being underneath and the coldness or something. So there's a little deck here, a little balcony that you can come out onto and, I don't know, read your newspaper in the morning or whatever it is you want to do. And this will be the inside bit with a little bit of I don't know if this will be a back balcony or maybe a hot tub. That seems like a good idea, something like that. But we are going to need a lot more logs to complete the build. So what I thought I'd do is get all of the packed ice stuff that I need. And this seemed like a good area to have as a central base because we can go off in this direction. And if I just go up here a little bit, I'll show you that there is a lot of this stuff around, and it's very easy to get as well. So you know, when you've got the efficiency 5 like I've got there, and of course you do need silk touch to get this, but you can see there it's just going through that like a knife through butter, and that is wonderful. So I get loads of this stuff really quickly, and I'm pretty much going to fill up these shulker boxes that I've brought with me, and then head home pretty much. If I do find a dark oak biome on the way, then I might just come back and touch this place up a bit, depending on how far away it is. And then we'll finish the episode once I get back to my base by finishing up the subscriber shout-outs and signs and that sort of thing. So yeah, I'll get on with the ice gathering, and then we'll have an update in a little bit. Well, as you can see, guys, we've got a bit of packed ice now. We've got this that's in my inventory here and a whole shulker box full of it. So that's pretty good going. Should be enough to keep us going for now. And my pickaxe has been worn down a fair bit there. Now, one thing I did want to do though before we left this area was to build a nether portal, because I suspect this will be the best way for me to come back in future. And I shouldn't have done that, should I? So I'm going to go to the nether and see what cords I get at the portal that we make there, and it'll probably be a lot easier for me to come back here then next time. So here we go. Alrighty. So we'll just let that lag die down a bit. And there's loads of quartz around here. This is awesome. When you spawn in a new nether area and it's this far away, you just have so much quartz. Now, the only thing I really wanted to do was get the quartz. So let's just do a screenshot as that. And then we can work out how to make a little nether tunnel to get back here next time. Alrighty. So, the other thing I wanted to do was get a screenshot of these cords right here, like that. And that's about it. So we're gonna head back to the base now. What I need to do is load up my end chest with all this good stuff here. So we'll start with this one. I love the way the shulker boxes are in the game now. It's just so easy to get loads of items, isn't it? And to transfer those items around with you, I should say. So that's empty, that's empty. We've got nether bricks and stuff in there. Probably want to save a lot of this ice as well, just in case. And yeah, we're about ready to fly home. Now my elytra, as you can see, didn't even go down to half durability on the way here. Therefore, we can get back. And should I leave my bed here? I might leave the bed and the ender chest here for now. I've got plenty of them. So yeah, that seems like a plan. Plenty of food on me. All right, guys, we're ready to head home. So I will now do that mostly off camera unless we find something interesting, because it is a fair journey. And I could go home through the nether, of course, but I want to go home on land in case there is that dark oak biome nearby that I see. I might better come back here and do some more work on that. But if not, then we'll do a bit of an update back at the base. Okay guys, as you can see, we are now here in the mineshaft area, and this is how we're going to finish the episode, by just going through the subscribers that did not make it for the start of the video, but have subscribed as I was recording this one. It does take me generally a day or two to record with working things around my my work life as well. So because of that, a couple came in the meantime. So here we have on the first door, we got Sid. Thank you, Sid. Slimy Diorite. Redneck Boy 1SF. We've got Mitch. Ogden, I did. Just Justin. Virginia Girl for the win. We got Ben Bishop. Mr. Kitty Guy 25. A Cool 317. So those guys, thank you for you and everybody else who has subscribed to me, everyone else who watches and likes these videos and everything else. All of the interactions I've had, Twitter, Instagram, it's been fantastic. Really want to say a big thank you to everyone. Very glad that there are a lot of people out there enjoying this content, and hopefully that will continue. So this is how all future subscribers will be added, guys. It'll be going on down here. And as I said, in future, I'm just, because of the sheer demand, I can't have everybody messaging me on Instagram and such. So it will be that those who subscribe, and it comes through YouTube, so you're not hiding your subscriptions and they are publicly available. That means I will get the email and then I can add you to this mineshaft going on down that way. So that brings us about to the end of this episode, guys. So once again, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.